The kingdom of heaven is likened to a man which sowed good seed in his field. We're talking about sowing. And then you have decided, I'm going to sow something good in the lives of other people. That's a field. I'm going to sow something good in the lives of my family. That's a field. I'm going to sow something good in the lives of my neighbors. That's a field. To sow the seed in his field. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. You have sown something good. Then the enemy comes, and then while men slept, because we are not watching, while men slept, then the enemy came to sow tares, bad seed, in the field, and then he went his way. That's why the Lord is calling us to watchfulness this year. That you protect what you sow, you preserve what you sow, you watch over what you sow, you make sure that what you, the harvest you want determines and dictates the things you are sowing. And then you just don't sow and then go away. You make sure that you are watching over it. That's why I'm talking about watchful sowers securing a desirable future. Look at verse 26. And when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So the servants of the household came and said unto himself, didst not thou sow good seed in thy field? From whence then has it tares? And he said unto them, an enemy has done this. You see that? An enemy has done this. I pray that the activities of enemies in your life, the Lord will cancel them in Jesus' name. But look at Genesis. Look at the application of this. Genesis chapter 15. Genesis chapter 15. That when you have sown your seed, when you have made a sacrifice, when you have given what you ought to give, watch over it. Watch over it. Don't allow the enemy to come to sow something bad into that while you are asleep. We're looking at Genesis chapter 15, verse 7. It says in verse 7, and he said unto him, I am the Lord that brought thee out of all of the Chaldees to give thee this land to inherit it. Your inheritance is for this year. And when God told Abraham that I brought you out, and then it's so that you will inherit something. It says, and he said, Lord God, whereby shall I know that I shall inherit it? And he said unto him, take me an heifer of 3 years old, and a she-goat of 3 years old, and a ram of 3 years old, and a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. Then he said, and he took unto him all these, and he divided them in the midst, and laid each piece one against another. And for the birds he divided not. And when the fowls came down upon the carcasses, Abraham did what? Drove them away. He had sacrificed it to the Lord. That's what I'm saying about what you sow this year. That you sow something in the field of the Lord, in the work of the Lord. You also watch over it so that it is protected, and so that the enemy will not come and then pollute everything. The service will not be polluted in Jesus' name. And when God had told Abraham to give all this, to sacrifice all this, like sowing also, that is, if you do this, Abraham, I'm going to bless you. And then he did it, and the fowls came to pollute, to defile, to corrupt, and to take away all those seeds he sowed unto the Lord. And then Abraham drove them away. Look at verse 18. Look at the result. In the same day, the Lord made a covenant with Abraham. This is the day of your covenant. When you sow that something good, and you make up your mind, I'm going to sow something good, and then you sow that, and the Lord makes a covenant with you, saying, unto thy seed have I given this land, from the river of Egypt unto the great river, the river Euphrates. The covenant of the Lord be confirmed in your life in Jesus. But remember, you need to watch. Mark chapter 13. You are watching over your own heart and over your own life. You are watching your surroundings so that what you are sowing to the Lord this year, no pollution will come, no defilement will come. Don't forget yourself. And then just slide back to what you used to do in times of carelessness the previous year, because this year is going to be different and unique and special and peculiar in our lives in Jesus' name. We're looking at Mark chapter 13, verse 35. Mark chapter 13, verse 35. Watch ye therefore. You're sacrificing to your, watch ye therefore. You lay anything on the altar this year, watch ye therefore. You brought all your offerings before the Lord, watch ye therefore. You're sowing a good seed in the lives of other people, watch ye therefore. For ye know not when the master of the house cometh at evening, or at midnight, or at the cock crowing, or in the morning, lest coming suddenly he find you sleeping. You will not sleep. And what I say unto you, I say unto all, watch. We're going to watch. It says in Romans chapter 13, watchfulness, watchfulness. While you are sowing, while you are sowing, you are also watching so that the enemy will not come and make a mess of the good thing that you are sowing. In Romans chapter 13, in there from verse 11, it says, that knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep. Don't sleep, because it is when we sleep that the enemy will come and sow tares in the field and sow some bad seed in the good seed that we are planting. It says, for now is our salvation nearer than when we believe. It's telling us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. I'm reading there from verse 6. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. We're looking at verse 6. Therefore, let us not sleep, because the enemy is watching for a careless moment. Christians, seek not yet repose. Hear thy guardian angel say, thou art in the midst of enemies, watch and pray. It says, therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. As we're sowing good things this year, we're going to watch and we're going to be sober. That when you do that, you preserve, you protect what you are sowing, good things are going to happen. In Isaiah chapter 32, Isaiah chapter 32, we're reading from verse 20. Isaiah chapter 32, verse 20. Blessed are ye that sow beside all waters. What does that mean? In your house, sow something good for the lives of the people there. Your local church district or sow something good in the lives of people there. And when we come together in our group of districts, sow something good. Just do something good. Just say, today, I don't want to miss out today. I've not done my sowing today. Sow something good. When we come together like this, together, sow something good. Whether it's a Sunday or our power now on, when we're going to have that bulldozer and clear the road, and then God is going to clear the road for you in Jesus' name. And then while you are coming in the buses, while you are coming on the way, you are sowing something good. You know, I wish you this. But you are wishing them hundredfold. You'll be healthy, hundredfold will come back to you. God is going to prosper, hundredfold will come to you. Don't curse anybody this year. Don't be angry at anybody this year. Just anything anybody does, just put a blessing upon them. A hundredfold will come.
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your heart. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week and the one we are going to listen to the next week. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, if you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.